we believe that every child should have the opportunity to go to college. And now, in a year 2020 workplace, they're going to need greater skills. They need to be proficient in reading, writing, math, and science. But they also need to be proficient in information literacy, economics, critical thinking, working in a team environment. So the demands and expectations have to be higher. In the past 5 years, we focus on having an effective teacher in front of every child. We've laid the groundwork for the next five-year plan. We want to graduate 90% of our students and 70% of those college and career ready.
Where planning is seeded at a very young age. I don't think it's uncommon for our elementary teachers to be talking to our kids about college in second, third, and fourth grade, which is a good thing because then it becomes an expectation at an early age. There's nothing more powerful than when someone tells you that they believe in you.
We're going to end social promotion by 2016. That means a lot of things. But it means that the practice of pushing kids along over time, from one grade to the next, because they showed up, that doesn't work.
They know education's important, and they have the support of everybody, not just mom and dad, grandmothers, godmothers. Everybody's very, you know, goal-oriented, and let's do this. You can get it done. They support education to the fullest.
I think what's important is that we develop a community-wide mentality around academic privilege.
The community has to believe that the students in Harrison School District, no matter the poverty level, no matter the home situation, they can be the same as any child in any school district.
In terms of the school's responsibility, we have to recruit the best and brightest teachers. We have to expose our kids to top quality. And we have to ensure that our teachers are providing our students with good first instruction. What our kids need to know is that we, as their teachers, as their principals, believe in them and that there's no reason they can't go to college.
With the new five-year plan, it's not just that kids in Harrison will go to college, it's that kids in Harrison can choose which college they will go to.
I have worked with lots of different students since I've been here, students who are impacted in some really tragic ways by situations that I just could never imagine. And I've seen people rise above that, and what I want them to understand is no dream is too big, that they can attain anything.
There's nothing that should stop our kids from going to college.
Sitting on the stage of graduation, we feel part counselor, part parent, part friend to these kids. I feel just a great sense of pride.
It brings tears to my eyes. This is my ninth grade graduation that I'll go through, and every single time it's the same emotion for me. It makes it all worth it.
Staff at Sierra High School goes above and beyond what it takes to get kids into school. If it means taking the kid on a college visit, there are people here who have taken kid on a college visit. If it means meeting with the kid at night to finish the application, they meet at night to finish the application. If it means tweaking the essay, we tweak the essay, and if it comes down to buying the books or dropping the kid off or moving furniture, that's what we do.
Separates us is our passion, and the reason we're successful is because the staff and the teachers and the administrators see that passion, even when we don't see it ourselves, and they go above and beyond in their efforts to find that passion and to bring it to the service and all of their students. That's what makes Harrison so great.
challenges is what makes life interesting. Overcoming them is what makes life meaningful. I want to prove statistics wrong. I want to prove people who never believe in me wrong. I want to prove ideas wrong. That's my main goal.
My mom always just tried to instill in me that knowledge is power and like that will take you far in life.
I don't want to drop out. I want to continue and I want to do something.
There's no excuse of not being able to go to college because there's loans, there's scholarships. You just have to put the effort to go get that. It's not just, I grew up in the poor. I can't get money to go to college. You can find the money somehow.
We all have like the same opportunities, it's just some of us have bigger aspirations, so we're going to go farther because some of us want bigger things in our life. Some of us just aren't going to take advantage of what we have.
A lot of my family hasn't even graduated from high school, so for me to be able to go to college and maybe even graduate would be a remarkable step for my entire family.
Because I want to make my parents proud. If I graduate, I'd be like the first one in my family too.
My mom has thyroid cancer, and it's spreading throughout her lungs and throughout her blood, and it's something that's really affected my life, and there is no cure for it. So I know if I become a chemical engineer or a medical engineer, I can make a difference in her world, in her life.
I'm just going to go to college because I want to have a better life, have a better future. There's a hope right there, and I want to make my hope come true.
I've learned a lot about critical thinking and about economics and viewing the world as being larger than Colorado Springs. If I work hard here, I can make a difference out there.
I have to work and grow my brain bigger. I'm excited to go to college.
My name is Justin and I'm going to college.
My name is Sean and I'm going to go to college.
My name is Gabriella and I'm going to college.
My name is James Kim and I'm going to college.
I am Selena and I'm going to college.
My name is Lyndon and I plan to go to college.
I'm Damien and I'm going to college.
At Fox Meadow, we're college bound.
Look for ways to engage our students. We've got some awesome students in the Harrison School District. And we need the community to stand behind these students, to be encouragers to these students, and look for ways to mentor some of these students who might be first generation to graduate from high school and certainly to graduate from college.
I believe in our kids, and I believe in our teachers. Do you?